I met you. I drink too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay. Hey, you tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. I know it breaks your heart, moved to the city in a broke down car, and 4 years no calls, now you're looking pretty in a hotel bar, and I can't stop. No, I can't stop. So baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford. Bite that tattoo on your shoulder, pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your roommate back in Boulder.
It's just, what's on your arm? It's just a light on your finger. It's okay. Well, there's Frosty. You're okay, baby. Hi,
you got deals again.
What? Yes, I see. It's okay. Yeah.
Right, and people don't get that.
Mm. There you go.
But you've given people a lot of things not to eat. What guidance have you
given? I know you don't feel well.
And she said, I love you, Mommy.
Oh, is that what you said? Oh, I love you too, sweetie.
You get it pretty soon, though. Look at her.
Hi, love. I will wipe your tears. No, I'm not going to use a Kleenex. Oh, right here, I got the tear.
Is it okay that she's crying?
Huh?
I got the tear right there.
She wants us to wipe her eyes.
I'll clean them out a little bit. They have goop in them.
That's good.
But that's to protect them. Yeah.
I've been busy. I'll get to her. I promise.
Hi, sweetheart. How are you? How are you feeling? Yeah, but it's better. We spoke to your doctor, your surgeon, and everything went very well. It looks great. Okay, here you go. I'm coming. Give me a second.
Okay.
I'm coming.
Do you want one from me too?
Yeah.
Not like that, though.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
You have to come over here.
I can't reach it from this side. Can I come around? Okay.
The beach.
Yeah, I think we had an ocean wave or something. We're walking through the beach, and this little girl's like super tired. What's that? Oh my god, I love you so much.
Just you. Nothing
like. Just a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh no.
You're able to be one chunk, okay? You need a second on it. Make it last.
Anyway. Oh, that unplugged my ears. Yeah, that was just horrible. But anyway, she's so cranky. And Jad's pulling her in the water. Or like, not pulling her, like, in the water, like, her face is face down in the water, but.
This was a video?
Yeah, it was a video. And his dad posted online. And they're just trying to get out of there. They're just trying to walk with this girl that's so tired. And she just plop on the ground. I was like, I'm going to take a nap. And he was like, you're going to take a nap? Yes, I'm going to take a nap right here. And she just falls in the sand and falls asleep.
Kind of like you did today. Getting ready to sit up for the first time.
She's been asking all day. It's okay.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how much the doctor has told you about the no bending, lifting, or twisting.
It pretty much is don't do any of it.
Perfect.
Yep.
So one of the times that comes into play is getting up out of bed. So normally at home you can probably either just sit straight up.
Yeah. Yeah. Roll over to my side and then push off the pillow.
Because
the popping up is going to be a lot of
bending. Yes. So roll over to your side first. So bend up your knees.
Look at you.
Then we're going to sit up here for a little bit.
I just peed, but I guess it's kind of normal to feel like you have to pee again.
If you want to try, we can put you up in the toilet.
Yeah. Don't get my butt. It's showing. Which I don't
cover.
I'm so much taller than you now. We used to be the same height.
Really?
So I apologize for the angle, but, oh my god, in my bandage on my back, there was this spot on my left side of my spine that was just pinching when I would lay on it and poke me, and we couldn't figure out what it was, so it's 9:30 p.m. on Thursday the 28th of September, and I went to the bathroom by myself, which I've been doing all day, and I was just feeling around, and I'm just like, there is something under my bandage. I could feel it, it was pokey, it was sharp, so I called my nurse in, and then of course, somehow, my call button got unplugged from the wall, so I couldn't call. I had gotten
like in bed. I was, you know, comfy, sitting, and my call button wasn't working. So I had to go all the way around to the other side, which I don't have a roommate right now, which is super cool. And so I used that call button. And a nurse came in, was looking, she's like, "It looks like you have a crumb under your bandage." I had a freaking crumb under my bandage. So she like took off her glove and like scratching at it, because she didn't want to just take the entire bandage off just for some little thing. So she took it off and, well, like she scratched it out of the bandage, I guess, and, you know, put a little band-aid on top of it so that, you know, my skin wasn't showing under my bandage. So, I need to sit up. My mom is at the Ronald McDonald House. My boyfriend's back in Richmond because he had to work today and has to work tomorrow. And I hopefully will get discharged tomorrow because I'm walking by myself. I'm going to the bathroom by myself. I think I'm going to ask if I can get like a sponge bath tomorrow because my hair is all nasty. But I'm kind of up now, so I think I'm going to watch some, oh no, it's so far away. I'm going to watch some Under the Dome, but it's literally so far away. I'm going to have to, like, log roll, grab it, and, like, pull it back. Anyway, just thought I'd update you guys a little bit. Yeah, today I had my grandpa come visit with his girlfriend, and it's been a pretty mellow day. I got released from the ICU, got put into my own room, which I share with literally no one.
Sorry, honey.
Sorry, if that's where you're hearing. Okay. Just as long as it's not pulling anything important.
No, don't worry. And it's a sutured in place, so please stop.
No, it's a pain in the neck.
Literally. Why are you plugging your ears?
Okay.
She's not
going to
scream.
It's got his senses wrong. I don't want to see, so I'm going to plug my ears.
You have to plug your ears for this.
I just woke up. Excuse my hair. I haven't brushed it since this morning, and I took a nap. My boyfriend's here. Nick is here. He went to go get stuff with my mom. I had a mishap this morning. I didn't want to put on tape. So, but one good thing, I went up and down 7 steps without help. Well, I had help going down, but no help going up, which is the hard part. And so PT cleared me to go home, but they're gonna let me go home tomorrow. They still have to get all the IVs and my drainage tube out, and I still have these things on me, which I don't know why. This morning, I was feeling good. I got up, went to the bathroom. They have, on the weekends, they have continental breakfast, where it's like, they'll have trays of stuff, and then they'll put it out, and you just pick and choose what you want, and you have to go out there by yourself. So, we did, I went out, I walked my wheelchair out there, and then I picked what I wanted, and I got tired, and so I sat down in my wheelchair, and I brought it back into my room. And I started eating. I was feeling hot, and I was, you know, just not feeling good. And my mom's like, "You need to eat. Like, eat." I'm like, "Mom, I'm, I am. My mom, just give me time." And I took off my gown, Philip took off the top of my gown because I got really, really, really hot. And they already had the AC on, and my mom was cold, so I didn't want them to turn it on some more. And it kept eating, and I threw it up. They said my stomach was too full for more solid food, and so my stomach was like, no, like, you're at full capacity. This was before I went to the bathroom, and so you're at full capacity, so it just threw it up. So that was not fun, throwing up while you're recovering from spinal fusion. Threw out my lower back real bad. And so after that, I went, I went back to bed. Came back into bed, laid here for a good long while, and I felt better. And so when my boyfriend got here, he hadn't seen me since the ICU because he had to go back to work Thursday and Friday, and I got out of the ICU on Thursday. And so I walked up to him, and he was just like, you're so beautiful, and, you know, look at that straight girl. And he was just like complimenting me and like almost making me cry, and he's just been so supportive. And so, like, I have never had someone in my entire life be as supportive like my mom as he is. And so we've got a big road ahead of us, but I will see you guys in the next clip. So I'm not going home today. They said for sure I'm not going home today. I was doing so good. And I have muscle spasms. And I can barely move this morning. Even after they gave me Valium. But at least they gave me a bath yesterday. So Nick stayed with me last night, and at like 5:30 this morning, he decided that he needed to go back to the Ronald McDonald House and sleep. And so took out my other IV on my right hand because apparently it wasn't even in the vein anymore, and blood was stuck in the actual, like, this part. So whenever they tried to flush it, it hurt so bad. And so we were waiting for an order for like an entire day to get it out, and it just kept turning and kept turning. And my nurse last night was just like, screw that, you know, I'll put the order in and I'm gonna take it out immediately, because it just, you know, you seem like you're in such amount of pain, and flushing it just hurts, and then it immediately pulls back out with blood. And so they took that out, and I'm gonna be here another day, so that's cool. I just hate that I'm gonna be spending less time with my mom at home, because she leaves on Thursday. But I'm gonna call my mom and Nick and have them come back and tell them